working on a new hunt. Gonna find some new stuff. We're gonna find some new stuff.
I'm not scared. Oh! I'm slightly scared. Okay.
We've got some big square buttons. Mm. You want a big square buttons? You got big square buttons. So show all the images really fast. So these are big square buttons. There's a 60 millimeter, 51 millimeter, and I think like a 40 millimeter. I'm gonna show them all next to each other. They're basically the same idea. There's this like black plastic case. There's a translucent white square in the middle. There's an LED that you can light up. It's like mechanical, tactile, so it's very clicky. Like I said, it comes in multiple sizes, and then that image shows, you know, one person that first video.
Clickety click.
It's like click, and we'll get more demos. So let's go to the overhead because I have to.
Clack clack.
I'll show them next to each other to compare the size, and I'll explain why I have these.
Clack clack.
You're probably like, why do you have
these? Why do you have these? Why do you have these?
Why do you have these? Okay, so that's the. This is the 44. Sorry, this is a 44, and this is the 50. So I got the numbers wrong. And this is the 60. I think I call it 51. But it's basically 45, 50, and 60. Okay. So now you're probably wondering, Lady Ada, why do you have these big square buttons? The reason is that we already had a square button in the shop. But I wanted to fit like an OLED or a TFT inside of it.
Oh.
Like in this space here, because there, you can remove the white part. I don't know if I'm...
Are you going to put a screen in there?
And I thought we could put a screen or something in there. Like you can... There's a little bit of space. But, you know...
You can make a macro pad. You can make a...
I just thought it'd be cool. Like maybe you could put like a 1.5 inch TFT display. Something
you
could press.
Could you put an e-ink display in there? I don't know.
You could put e-ink maybe. Yeah. Oh. I don't know. I wanted to experiment, but I also thought like, okay, well, it's always, you know, big buttons are always...
Yeah, when the big buttons get big enough, eventually they can be... A display.
Yeah. So this is some big clicky buttons. They all have a tactile switch. You can take them apart. So they do have like an LED. The LED.
Oh, I know what we'll use it for. What? We'll use it for the thing that you just assigned to Tyeth.
That's right. That's what I already did.
Oh, this is the button.
Yeah, these are the buttons.
Okay. Yeah, we have a really neat project. Okay. This.
Yeah. I already did. It's already been done. He already bought them.
Oh, okay.
Okay. So, right. So it's a clicky. There's clicky. There's this LED. The LED is separate. It's lit up separately. And I'll say the LED is not that, it's not like super bright. If you want, you could replace it with like a diffused, like a 5 millimeter LED. Maybe it would show up a little bit better. Honestly, the light up isn't so great. If you don't want to put a TFT like me, because you're not crazy, you could also just put a cutout, either translucent or paper, and it will show, you know, square, it'll show up very nicely. But just big square buttons. They're great. This one is like enormous, huge. And this one is like, kind of tiny, and this one is just right. So it's big square buttons. We also, of course, have the 33 millimeter one, but that one is much too small, I think. Okay, so that's buttons. Let's keep
okay.
going.
Okay. Next up, Lady Ada, we've got this thing. What does this thing do?
Okay. Oh. So these are, and that goes with this.
Yeah.
So this is, you asked for this. This is a this is a USB cable with USB-C on the end, where the USB-C rotates like any direction, 180.
So yeah,
like,
you'd be surprised.
Rotate actually, all the way around 360.
You need this for all sorts of things because everything has a USB-C, and sometimes it's camera stuff, sometimes it's lighting, sometimes.
And you're always like, I want it to go out at a weird angle, and so I was like, fine, I'll stock these for you. So they there's a 1 meter and a 2 meter. I'll say the only thing that's different is this one has the LED like built into the body, and apparently the sample was different than the final ones, but that's okay. So the LED is a little bit different. There's a 2 meter version. They're kind of like cyberpunky. They're USB-C on one end.
Yeah, they look cool too.
USB-A 2.0 on the other. So they're not for like ultra high speeds. But here's the thing. That connector can only pass USB 2.0 signals anyways.
Yeah.
It is data and charge. So it's both. You get all four signals through. But it's, and it works both ways, right? Like you can flip the connector.
Yeah, it's good for like dongles and stuff too. If you have to like move them around and have... a laptop and you have to like tuck the dongle and you don't want to like pull the cord. There's a lot of, I found these useful and I just tossed it in my bag. And
yeah. We have. Okay. So that's that. Okay. And then.
Okay. The star of the show tonight, besides you, Lady Ada, our customers, our team, and everybody who shares and makes this thing go is.
And then the OPT 4048, which is like you said, is the product of the week, which why the code is XYZ color. So this is a XYZ color sensor. What that means is that it doesn't give you RGB data output. It's like, you know, usually you get like 0 through 255, red, green, and blue. This one actually gives you CIE color, X and Y, which can be converted into color temperature. It also gives you lux output. And it's like a well-calibrated sensor specifically for light temperature reading, which is why it doesn't have like a light on. Like usually color sensors have a reflective light on it that will let you reflect light off of the thing you're sensing. But that's not what these sensors are used for.
I've never seen that word, tristimulus.
Tristimulus.
That's a cool word.
Tristimulus?
Yeah.
Yeah. Isn't there like a book about that? Like
it sounds like a planet.
The trisimulus
problem. Well, it sounds like a planet where everything is made out of threes.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Very unstable. Okay, so I can show this on
the head.
I got just a quick demo that I just threw together real fast.
Tri-stimulus.
It's tri-stimulus. So this is just an ESP32 with it. And you can see, so it's, you know, I'm kind of moving it around, but it can measure the color temperature of the ambient light here, which is 2800, 2900 degrees K. That's about right because we have like fairly warm indoor lighting because we're in a house. And then, you know, what I can do is I can mess with the light since I've got my, you know, my phone.
Yeah.
And then when I do this, the lux goes up to 2000. The color temperature gets a little cooler. It gets like 3,000, 3,100.
Oh, yeah. So there was an observation in one of the chats, but I just want to confirm. Yeah. Can you test like the LED lighting? Like, could you be able to test LED stuff?
Yeah, like if you're like, is this a warm, cool, and what temperature is the LED? It's not going to tell you like, I mean, you can use the X and Y to find like what color emission it is, but like the thing it's really good for and what it's really designed for is color temperature. Of like lighting. So, you know, I think it's actually used, I think a lot of times this is, you know, used for sensors, of course, but it's used for televisions and monitors where they want to change the ambient light will be detected. And then they might change the lighting of your device to tell, to like, to make it look better under different lighting. Cause you know, it's like colors
when it's
look different.
Dark, you want the dark to look different. Yeah.
You want things to look different under different lighting conditions and different color temperature conditions. So it's a scientific sensor, but it solves the problem very well. And it's very inexpensive to use. And we also made a little web app that you can use with this, and we'll show a video after.
I like this. You can do so many things because you get the data and like make music out of it. So many things you do.
Okay.
All right. And that is New Parts Idea.
Yep.